Jimmy, you're driving. You've not just nailed it, you've absolutely cinched it.
Yes, mate. So we're in Burnley, my hometown, with Cinch today. So I'm going to show you the sights.
I'm looking forward to it. What have you got for me?
Show you my cricket ground. And then we're going to go to see Steve, who's the chairman of junior cricket at Burnley. And we're going to surprise him and play some street cricket with him. So it'll be good.
Yeah.
Enjoy.
Yeah.
Sit back and enjoy, mate. I'll do the driving.
Nice car, isn't it? Nice car.
It is a nice car. It's a good all-rounder.
Yeah.
Yeah. Plenty more of them coming.
What age did you start playing at Burnley, Jim?
I can't remember exactly how old, but my dad used to play there, so I used to go down as like from a toddler, really.
Really, okay.
And then start getting competitive at like 8 or 9, I guess.
Always a bowler from that age?
No, I was pretty rubbish at both. Really? I was a fielder. I won Fielder of the Year 3 times in a row for the third team. So.
Most improved.
Yeah. Team Man of the Year.
Go on then, Jimmy, what have you got for me in terms of Australia? What should I expect first Ashes tour?
It's exciting. It's exciting, mate. The crowds are different. It's a special place to play, and obviously with the Ashes having so much history, it just makes it that bit more special, I think.
Yeah.
You knowing that the players that have played at those grounds scored the runs that they have, taken the wickets they have.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just really special.
Okay, Jim, do you fancy a little bit of a quick fire this or that?
Let's do it.
Come on. Vegemite or Marmite?
Neither.
Yeah,
well, absolutely disgusting.
Yeah. Rugby or Aussie rules?
Rugby.
Yeah.
Can't get my head around Aussie rules at all.
Neighbours or Coronation Street?
Oh, wow, that's a toughie, isn't it?
I've watched neither, so this is all.
You've watched neither?
No.
Oh, my God, what have you been doing? Oh, Neighbours. Controversial.
Ooh. Bondi Beach or Blackpool Beach?
Oh, God. Bondi Beach.
I don't think they've helped us here with these questions either.
Too many pebbles on Blackpool Beach.
That's a lot of Australian answers here, Jim. Warney or Swanee, it says here. Before you think
well, as a bowler or a bloke?
That's entirely up to you.
For a bowler, I'd go Warney, and for a bloke, I'd go Warney.
McGrath or Broad?
Ooh. McGrath. Oh. Sorry, Stu. Yeah,
Broad, I'm picking you, don't worry.
Sorry, mate.
Hattrick or Pfeiffer?
Pfeiffer, I think.
I've had
you?
Both as well, to be fair.
You've
so,
had both?
Yeah. Probably Wixman, yeah.
Amazing. This is a real journey. I'm taking you on a journey. You're taking me on a journey as well with this information I'm getting. Incredible.
Yeah. Finally, your best Aussie accent, please.
Good day, mate. Put another shrimp on the barbie. Go on.
You absolutely cinched that.
No. I've cinched it. Yes, mate. Coming up to Burnley Cricket Club, where the magic happened.
The place that made the man that is sat driving me around Burnley as England's highest wicket taker.
Great memories there.
Yeah. Go on, your favourite memory at this club?
Winning the league.
Yeah.
I went back in 2006, I played for England, got injured and then went back for the last sort of 7 or 8 games.
Right. I'll say you played a decent amount then, yeah.
Yeah, batted at 5. Top scorer, 32, I think.
Yeah.
bowled a little bit. But yeah, we ended up winning the league. Oh. And I was actually batting when we knocked off the runs to win the league.
Oh, brilliant.
So it was really special, yeah.
Nice.
Burnley Cricket Club was where I met most of my good friends, and I'm still mates with a lot of guys that were down there.
Yeah.
We had a really good friendship group growing up.
Cool, so that was Burnley. Now we're going to Steve's house, aren't we? Looking forward to that.
Yeah, looking forward to seeing his face when we surprise him. Let's go and see him. It's a good drive.
It's nothing like a good drive, is it?
Nothing like a good drive. I can't remember the last time I actually played a drive in an international game.
Still, right?
All right, Steve.
How are you doing?
You all right?
Not bad, you?
Hi, mate. Steve, nice to meet you.
Are you okay?
Yeah, very good, thanks. How are you?
We've come to surprise you, and basically we want to thank you for all the hard work you've done for Burnley Greek Club, and the junior section in particular. We've got a few gifts for you.
We've got a couple of signed balls from Jimmy and myself here, and then obviously a couple of captain t-shirts, so if I could just give me that.
We've brought some kit as well, if you fancy a game of street cricket with the kids. Are you all right?
Oh, I'll tell you now, it's a genuine edge.
Hey.
Do you want me to start?
You go, because you know where we are. I don't know where we are.
My first car was the family heirloom. Weirdly, I broke up with a boyfriend and my dad gifted it to him. Since you asked.
How many cricket balls would weigh the same as this Ford Cougar?
Have you ever carried the cricket ball bag? It gets heavy quite quickly.
Well, I haven't carried a Ford Cougar either.
Oh, that was close.